So I'd like to talk about a method that I use to teach my students when they're serving and they're beginning to put a slice on the ball, a kick or a twist on the ball. And it really has to do with paying attention to the contact point. And it isn't exactly a point. And I think that's where we need to look at it. And I hope this video will show you that. I'm going to draw a line around this ball. And that's the equator of the ball, the lower half and the upper half of the ball. So it's there. And then I'm going to draw a line so that we really have a good visual of the bottom hemisphere. Not a bad idea for you to do this yourself if you want a training ball or something just to give you something to remember and recall. But look what I've done to the bottom of the ball here. I have an upper hemisphere and I have a lower hemisphere. When I'm slicing the ball on the serve, the ball is traveling up. As it's falling back down, I need to only see the bottom hemisphere of the ball as it's falling. And I imagine that this is the only area that I'm making contact with the ball as I'm brushing across. Not at the hemisphere and not above. If I'm doing that, the opportunity for me to get too high or allow the ball to drop too low, I'm going to drive it into the net. I'm making contact at the bottom hemisphere of the ball as I brush underneath the ball. And there's a lot of contact. If my hand with the racket, look how open it is as I come across the ball to get that slice. So a level hemisphere as I'm coming across, that's going to give me a slice. As a right-hander, it's going to travel from my right to my left side. If I turn the hemisphere a little bit on a 45-degree angle, and I'm going to get a kick or a twist, actually, at this angle, again, I'm looking at contacting the bottom hemisphere of the ball only as I brush across. That is what drives the maximal amount of spin, not the hemisphere. Because if I'm too far ahead of it, again, I'm going to drive that ball down. I need to be driving it up first. Focus on the bottom hemisphere. This angle gives you a ball that travels to your opponent's right side, and then as it hits the ground, it jumps to their left side, 45-degree angle. Again, here in the States, we call that the American twist. Now, a kick is straight up and down, the two hemispheres on either side. I'm making contact on the outside of the ball as I'm rolling over, not the hemisphere. The hemisphere and below. As I hit that, that ball spin, travels, hits the ground, and then jumps out at my opponent. It has made a tremendous amount of success with my students when they start to visualize the entire bottom half of the ball is where they're making contact. Now we're talking about the brush and the kick and the spin and the slice. A flat ball is going to be different. A flat ball, we're still coming up, and that would be definitely, you know, making center contact as best you can, still coming up from below the ball should be traveling up before it drops. And with that in mind, if I'm brushing across, I'm under the ball as I'm brushing, it's going to travel up before it drops. I'm not tall enough to drive the ball straight down like John Isner. Give it a try. See if just visualizing the bottom hemisphere of the ball makes a difference in your contact and the amount of spin or slice or kick. And let me know. Send me some comments. Send me questions if you have them. Draw this out on a ball so that you're really looking at it. Take a marker, bottom hemisphere, you're making contact across. Demonstrate a few examples of that ball contact where visually I'm looking at the bottom hemisphere of the ball as it comes down. And have a look at me from the back. We'll try looking at it from the side and see if you can catch the action on the ball as well as my contact. I'm not going to do a full serve. It's going to be more controlled so that you can see a little bit more of just the action on the ball. And it's really how you should begin learning this serve anyway. If you're going full guns and trying to overhit the ball, your technique may just be falling apart. And spend time not doing a whole lot, getting underneath that ball on the swing and just making good contact. Don't worry about so much of your feet. Let's give it a shot and see how it goes. Again, as I'm tossing this ball, and if you watch my other videos, the technique with that open face fence, if you've looked at me doing the climb the fence, but as I swing the racket face in slow motion, you really realize how much more open it is. I'm looking at the ball as it's falling down, but I'm considering that bottom half, that bottom hemisphere of the ball, and I'm brushing across the bottom hemisphere to get the action on it. So if I'm hitting a slice, bottom half, hopefully you can see that on the other side, that is what's causing the ball to have a lot of spin, and my desired slice is coming out of it. Let's look at that again. So I'm coming across the bottom edge. I don't like to say edge anymore. I say the bottom hemisphere of the ball. That's really where my attention is as I'm watching the ball fall before I strike it. Let's try that again. Now, if I toss it a little bit further out to the side and I get that much more open face on it, I get a little bit bigger slice. So again, not my full swing. I'm just working on the action. Let's move down to the other side so you can see what that looks like. So I'm gonna slice this ball. My attention is the bottom hemisphere of the ball as I see it falling down from my toss. That's the action that I want. This is not a to serve. Hopefully you can see the action on it. My attention again is just the bottom half. That gives the brush coming across. So let's look at the American twist, where now the hemisphere or the equator of the ball is not level, it's at a 45 degree. And my contact is, again, the bottom hemisphere of the ball as I brush. That gives me the action on the ball that travels from the right-hand side of my opponent to their left-hand side. And you can see it there. Again, these are just simple serves, understanding that it's the bottom edge. So let's turn that hemisphere vertically up and down. Again, I'm on the outside or the bottom hemisphere, the original bottom hemisphere, to create a kick. The ball has to be tossed a little bit over me, but you'll see that my orientation is on the bottom half, the lower hemisphere of the ball.